In this video, we will make a robotic joint actuator similar to the ones in the legs of Boston Dynamics Spot or Ghost Robotics Dog. This actuator will be based on a ball screw and ball nut, a powerful brushless motor, an ODrive servo controller board, and a magnetic encoder. At the end of the video, we will test it and see how powerful it is. We will start from a 50mm aluminum tube in which we will open a window and drill two holes for the joint shaft. The holes for the shaft will not be in a diameter of the tube, but in a lower position. We will install two bearing blocks to hold the shaft. Before that, we need to adapt the curvature of the tube with a 3D printed part. Similar adapters are used in the inner part. The ball screw and ball nut model is commonly used in 3D printers. We will remove this threaded part to make it shorter. We will use another bearing block for holding this side of the ball screw, but before installing it, we will open a groove for the encoder cables. Now we can install the bearing block, which will take radial loads. We will add a thrust bearing since forces of the ball screw will be mainly axial. A 10mm coupler will join the ball screw and the motor shaft. We have drilled the ball screw and the coupler to install a pin that will prevent motion between them. A 3D printed spacer will hold everything centered in the tube. None of the 3D printed parts are structural. The brushless motor model is commonly used in electric skateboards and has a very high torque, 6 Nm. A laser cut aluminum disc will adapt the motor to the ball screw set. A 3D printed disc is used to hold some nuts. Now we can assemble the motor set. The shaft coupler can be tightened through a window. Now we will install the magnetic encoder. Here you can see the magnetic sensor. I have already soldered the wires to connect it to the controller. A 3D printed part will link the encoder to the ball bearing. A cover is used to protect the electronics. In this side, you can see the magnetic sensor. Now we install another ball bearing with an external clip. And the magnet for the encoder is glued to the ball screw. The distance between the magnet and the encoder must be less than 3mm. Now we will build the output rods. A connecting rod is built in a similar way. A ball bearing is used to allow the rods to slide along the tube. The connecting rod is joined to the output rods with a pin. The ball bearing will slide between two aluminum parts. These parts are fixed to the tube with rivets. Now we must prevent the ball nut from rotating. We will do it with a 3D printed part that will slide along an aluminum profile. The aluminum profile is also riveted to the tube. It will also be used to guide the encoder cable. We insert some nuts for fixing the whole set to the tube, and we assemble the whole set. Now we will connect the crank to the output rod and to the joint shaft. The crank is a laser-cut steel part. The joint shaft is an 8mm bolt. We will use two nuts to fix the crank. Finally, we put a cover to close the tube. Here you can see the final result, with a link resembling a robotic leg. The actuator is easily back-drivable, as you can see. For testing the leg, we have fixed it to a table. We have connected the encoder cable to an ODrive controller board. The motor power cables are also connected to it. The board is connected to a 6S battery and to the laptop. After the initialization sequence, we test the maximum angular speed. For testing the maximum force, we have connected the link to a spring and a counterweight. Finally, using only the spring, we can see that the force exceeds 20 kg or 60 Nm. Thanks for watching!